In this video, we'll take a look at how to use the Usage Today overview in the Emaldo app. Let's start by opening the app. The home screen of the app is built up by widgets. If you want to learn more about that, then there's also a video that goes through how the widgets work and how to customize the home screen. But for now, let's tap the first widget here. Then it pops up in a bigger view. Let's scroll down to Usage Today, then tap it. Usage Today gives you full overview of how your Emaldo system manages the power in your home. Here in the first view, you can see how much energy you have used today in your household. Below the graph, there are three different categories that you can either include or exclude from the overview. This makes it easy to find out what uses energy. Let's try to click on the different categories to see what it does to the graph. As you can see, when removing Keep on Load from the graph, it only has a small influence on the graph. And when removing additional load, then there's no other power used today, meaning that the EV charger hasn't been used to charge a car today. If we only select the Keep on Load, then we can see when the backup unit consumed power. Even though this is a very little consumption, we now know how much energy has been used by the Keep on unit. If you tap and hold on the graph, then you can move your finger around to see the energy used every 5 minutes. Now let's include the other categories again. To view electricity consumption of yesterday, we must tap the arrow in the left side. Here you can see the energy used yesterday. Let's find out when the EV was last charged. If we exclude everything else than vehicle, then we can see how much energy that has been used to charge the EV. As you can see, there's no energy used by it yesterday either. So let's go back a few days until we find a day where the vehicle has been charged. Now we found a day where the vehicle has been charged. You can find the date in the top of the screen. As you can see, the vehicle has been charged during the night, but we can only see when the charging ended. If we go back one more day, then we can also see when the charging began. It started charging around 2035 with 9.6 kilowatt power. If we select the two other categories, then we can see how much power has been used in total. If you want to have an overview of the last weeks instead of days, you'll need to press here in the top right corner. Choose week. Now there's an overview of the current week. And as you may have noticed, there's now a new category called Power Peak. Power Peak adds a new layer on top of the energy usage graph. It's useful to find the maximum energy load of each day. Let's go back to the last week, where we can see a full week's data. The different colors in the graph corresponds to the different categories, where the light blue is the vehicle consumption. Now let's try choosing the month view instead of the week view. Here you can see the current month. We can also press year to see the current year. Let's see what the energy consumption was like last year. The total usage was a whopping 11.3 megawatt hours. Let's check the last option in the range menu. Choose lifetime, which shows all the different years. This was how to use the first tab of this page. Let's go further to the next one. This view shows how much energy has been charged to or discharged from the Emaldo system. The first graph shows when and how much energy that has been charged or discharged during the day. And the second graph shows the battery percentage of the Emaldo system during the day. It's also possible to change what data is being shown by pressing Battery Net Stats. Here you can choose between two other options, discharged and charged. Let's choose discharged. Remember to tap Confirm. All it does when changing to discharged or charged is showing only one of the things, whereas Net Stats shows both the energy that has been charged and discharged. But if you change to the Charged tab, then you can see what actually has charged the battery and provided power to the house. You can see the three categories: solar energy, solar joule, and grid energy. Solar energy and solar joule are the energy generated by the solar panels. Solar energy is the solar panels connected directly to your Emaldo system. And solar joule is solar panels connected to an already existing inverter that's connected to your Emaldo system. And grid energy is, of course, that energy that has been supplied via the grid. You can play around to see what energy is from solar panels and what is from the grid. If we now go back to the net stats view, then as with the first tab, you can also choose what day you want to view. And again, you can also choose the data range. Now let's go to the next tab. Here you can see how much energy has been produced by the solar panels. Because this app is connected to an Emaldo power core, we have four different categories: MPPT1, MPPT2, MPPT3, and solar joule. On a power store unit, you will only see solar joule, which again is the surplus production from your existing solar panels. The MPPT categories are the different outputs from your solar panels. By unselecting some of them, it's possible for you to see only some of the outputs. And here it is also possible to change the data range between days, weeks, years, and lifetime. Now let's go to the fourth tab. Here you can see how much energy is imported to and exported from the grid. If you want to only see the imported or exported energy, you can tap here to do so. And of course, it's still possible to show earlier days or change the view to months, years, or lifetime. And now let's check out the last tab. This view shows the fluctuations of the energy price through the day. In the top, we have the price of selected time slot in percentage. And right next to it is the price peak, which is where the price is most expensive. At 0% in the middle is the average price of the electricity. Right here where we have chosen a time slot, you can see the price is 42.69% cheaper than the average price of today. We can also choose one of the red time slots, where the price says it's 71.31% more expensive than today's average. You can use this view to find out when the energy prices are higher or lower during the day. I hope you found this tutorial useful and have learned something new. Remember to check out some of our other tutorials if you need more help. But for now, thanks for watching and have a great day.